सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म्स लाइक फेसबुक, ट्विटर, यूट्यूब, इंस्टाग्राम प्रोफाइल मेक्स पीपल्स लाइफ लुक अ लॉट मोर एक्साइटिंग देन इट इज। आई डोंट हैव अ प्रॉब्लम एडमिटिंग दिस फैक्ट। आई थिंक इट्स जनरल असम्पशन अमंग यूजर्स दैट सोशल मीडिया इज मोर ऑफ अ हाईलाइट रील ऑफ अ पर्सन्स लाइफ देन एन ऑथेंटिक डॉक्यूमेंट्री ऑफ इट। अ स्टडी शोज मोर देन हाफ क्लेम्ड दैट दे पोस्टेड इमेजेस टू कॉज जेलसी and success among their followers. Stick around as we break down and dive in deeper to finally realize what it takes to sacrifice and succeed on social media. Being verified on social media is something that everyone wants, yet very few ever see that mysterious blue tick show up on their account. It's the ultimate ego stroke that exists today. Everyone lives on social media these days, so being verified is a big deal. At least it is to the people that desire it so bad. Now ask those that do have the verification badge and what it has done for them, and most will say not too much. But this is coming from pretty successful people that are used to things being thrown their way. It isn't going to mean you will receive thousands of new follower requests. You won't become rich overnight, but it does give you almost instant credibility that you can use to build your personal brand and expertise. Twitter is the originator of the verification check. They released it without much mention after the social network launched, and it was given to a few early celebrity influencers. Most people were introduced to Twitter through a celebrity, and I can remember Ashton Kutcher being one of the first true celebrity supporters of Twitter. Twitter gave these people a verified check mark so its users would know that they were interacting with the real person and not an imposter. That was the original purpose of the verification check, to let early adapters know they were communicating with celebrities. Twitter was the first social network to allow anyone to reach out and message celebrities, and that was part of the reason why it was a very unique network. They have never publicly stated how they verified accounts or how an account qualifies for verification, and will forever remain a mystery. Most people think that follower count is something that social media platforms considers when verifying accounts. I can tell you from first-hand experience that follower count does not mean a thing. I have seen accounts with several million followers get passed on and overlooked, while accounts with a couple hundred followers get a substantial amount of success. A lot of people will fire off fake followers onto their accounts, thinking that if social media platforms sees their follower count shoot through the roof, that they will automatically verify and make them a success. They can easily filter out fake followers. So I can promise you that if you take this approach, your account will get passed on and probably flagged internally as a never verified account. Money motivates people and makes them do the best they can for their brand. When we are successful, we are rewarded. When someone clicks the buy now button, we are motivated through triggers to capitalize on that response even more. There is no straight and easy way to make money online. Most people use a platform to create opportunities for the business in order to make the money, but there is still not a direct way to the money. More and more brands who are successful on social media focus on the conversation and engagement with the potential buyer. Businesses who put a human face to their brand are the ones doing the best on social media. When you can put a face to your brand, more people will be inclined to have a conversation with you, engage with you, and remember who you are after the fact. Scientific research has revealed that the psychological triggers involved with adding a human face to your brand can make the experience more memorable for the customer and build trust. People seek out relevance in this internet world, and the brand who shows their face to the public is already three steps ahead of the rest of us because they play to our emotional psychology. Online business growth is more than just building links now. The successful social media entrepreneur actively engages their followers and potential customers on their respective platforms. While people may not make a sale right off the bat, they are looking for results from playing the long game on social media. Social media influencers publish videos, images, and motivational stories on social media channels such as Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. But their presence is different to the average user. An influencer has a solid base of fans who follow the content for entertainment or inspiration. In return, these followers indicate their employment and appreciation by liking, sharing, and commenting on photos, links, and videos, while influencers get paid through advertising. The number of people following and the number of likes and comments is currency in the social media world. It enables influencers to build a reputation and stand out from all of us who use social media to interact with friends. Most social media influencers have their own specialist expertise areas which they are passionate about or develop as a hobby. The relationship also involves interacting with them by asking for their views and recommendations, as well as crucially thanking them and publishing content they ask to be posted. It's common for influencers and entrepreneurs to start with their own interests and hobbies to generate a number of likes and followers, which leads to a boost in self-confidence. Ultimately, it's this confidence that motivates influencers to carry on posting. However, as with any euphoria-linked activity, there are also negative outcomes. People found that influencers are empowered through their increased confidence, but that anxiety, social media fear, and insecurity are common traits too. Influencers revealed that they felt afraid their followers would perceive them as being too image conscious, or that they would see them as being too focused on their brand image rather than their community of fans. They've also faced anxiety through constant comparison with other social media users. On Instagram, influencers are constantly comparing themselves to others and wondering why their pictures were not getting as many likes or why it didn't look a certain way. As people engage on social media with greater frequency, we find ourselves sitting through photos of children, commentary about food, and explosive reactions to current political events. This increased media usage and exposure, which begs the question, how accurate is the information we are getting? More specifically, how honest are these influencers and people on social media sites? The truth is that people tend to lie on these platforms. First, people directly lie about their lives, which is often an effort to make themselves look more desirable or positive. Even more commonly, people lie by presenting an image of themselves and their lives that is imprecise or less than comprehensive, leading the viewer to believe falsehoods. When people engage on social media, their trust is met with overt lying and less than honest presentations. It can be problematic because people internally presume that what is presented is true, that influencers and entrepreneurs are naturally as good-looking as their photos appear on a daily basis, that people's daily home life is as perfect as the pictures depict, that others have very few gut-wrenching struggles, that people around us are in a habitual state of going on vacation, eating out, and parenting blissfully, This is clearly not true. But although we are less aware of the realities of other people's lives, we are well aware of the ways in which our own lives are not ideal. The life of an influencer and entrepreneur. It's all free meals, glamorous holidays and posing, am I right? It can certainly look that way from the outside. So it's not surprising that being an influencer is one of the most popular career aspirations for kids nowadays. But despite the apparently glamorous and fun lifestyle, influencers get a lot of hate. Influencers seem to constantly be making headlines for doing something stupid, be it launching weekly giveaways that are not weekly or asking their followers to fundraise $11,000 so they can go on vacation. However, the ones doing these quite frankly stupid things really are the exception which give the whole industry a bad name. Yes, of course there are some influencers who are self-indulgent, lack integrity and are in it for the freebies. Most people have no idea quite how much time, effort and work goes into running a successful Instagram feed, Facebook, YouTube and many more. If it looks like an influencer and entrepreneur is living the 24/7 dream, that's because they want you to think that. In reality, a lot of work goes behind the scenes to create that image. Essentially, you are a photographer, journalist, director, producer, model, critic, PR and personal assistant to yourself all at once. They have to learn everything from marketing to the depths of SEO. Develop strong negotiation skills, create content every day and maintain a strong connection with their audience. It's 24/7 and it won't stop. What's more, when you are the brand and the product, you are opening yourself up to a lot of criticism and that's not easy. Influencers and entrepreneurs have witnessed a social media fail sometime in their life. It usually results from a sense of urgency or a miscommunication that ignores common sense, all for the sake of gaining attention. For best example, everyone was excited when Pepsi joined hands with Kendall Jenner to promote their brand. However, the partnership ended up on the failed social media campaigns due to a listing of poor planning. Pepsi came up with a new social media campaign called Life For Now with the aim to connect with the new generation and celebrate the spirit of social protest movement, one of which included popular Black Lives Matter campaign. The company's reach exceeded its grasp when it released a promotional video starring Kendall Jenner. It did not take too long for the campaign to receive backlash from all corners. Most criticized the company for insulting protesters and showing that a can of Pepsi can solve world problems. If you search negative celebrity influencers, you will come across a number of influencer names who have been at the forefront of some of the worst social media fails over the years. The truth is that you can never be sure of a social media campaign. It can go either way. Though it may seem hard to believe, many organizations are still in the beginning stages of including social media in their marketing and communications mix. Some are embarking on a new venture, others are finally ready to become more digitally present and engaged, and still others are regrouping and all looking to optimize their existing commitments. Social media today is a big challenge than ever before. It's far more difficult to do it effectively, but not many people will tell you that. There's still a fair bit of emphasis on easy, fast, cheap approaches and a tendency to promise outcomes that are difficult. Organizations and influencers that are just now establishing a presence on social media platforms like Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter and YouTube will face significant growth challenges. It is much harder today to get people to subscribe, like or follow on any social media platform, especially the established ones. The kind of growth numbers that were easily attainable just a few years ago are now nearly impossible to get it if you are not a big band or celebrity or focused on a topic people feel very passionate about. Influencers, organizations, entrepreneurs likely hold on to surprising sacrifices, including 14% of their sleep and 10% of their sex life, which results in high amount of rich, successful entrepreneurs ending in divorces and marriage problems, not being able to spend time with their children or their wife and their closest friends, thus resulting to a potential self-questioning: was it all worth it? Then sooner or later they come up on the news for suicidal attempts and drug overdose and many more. Every entrepreneur starts out with big dreams and excitement. As an entrepreneur, you control your own destiny, and with the right ideas, the right skill set and unflinching dedication, you can build wealth or establish an enterprise to serve as your legacy. This is the bright side of entrepreneurship. But unfortunately, there's also a darker side. The rigors of entrepreneurship demand sacrifices, and if you don't make those sacrifices, you'll never be able to succeed. Business is at its core a give and take process. Entrepreneurs starting a new venture is always a risk. There's no guarantee they are going to succeed. The foundation of the company, even if the idea and plans are rock solid at its best, there's no telling which direction business is headed until they are several months or often much longer into running things. If they have not already sacrificed their comfortable, well-paying, stable job to follow this route, or so they'll have to sacrifice some other kind of stability before moving forward. Entrepreneurship is by nature an unstable path to follow. Don't be surprised if you encounter multiple unpredictable shifts in your fortune as your work progresses. When people become an entrepreneur, the lines between their work life and personal life will blur. Despite its importance, understanding of what entrepreneurial disappointment is, its attributions, and how it relates to depression. Because founding a venture involves setting hopes and expectations under conditions of uncertainty. Disappointment is a highly relevant topic for entrepreneurship. An entrepreneur could attribute disappointment resulting from a poor funding outcome to the ignorance of investors or their own shortcomings when pitching. Because there is no systematic investigation of the causes entrepreneurs attribute their disappointment, nor the disparate associations those attributions might have with mental health, and we do not know the nature of the link between entrepreneurial disappointment and depression. Disappointment is a prevalent, discrete emotion that is neglected in entrepreneurship research. Disappointment theory states that disappointment is an emotional reaction that arises from an individual's expectations and a realized outcome.